folks. Welcome back to the Roots and Reach of Music. This is Suzy Q, and thanks for listening today. It is clear that the world of early Delta blues was a small world with a long reach. The musicians' lives and music were intertwined with one another and the contemporary artists they inspired. Bob Dylan, Eric Clapton, and the Rolling Stones all found inspiration in the Delta blues style and are just a few of the musicians who repeatedly cite the work of the early artists and often recorded their songs. Son House, born in 1902, features prominently in the work and lives of his musical contemporaries, as well as many artists of today. He had a formative influence on Muddy Waters, and Son House was reportedly with Robert Johnson when Johnson made his pact with the devil to gain musical prowess. House, having been convicted of murder, also spent some years in the Mississippi State Penitentiary, known as Parchman Farm, where Booker White, also serving time, wrote his hit, Parchman Farm Blues. Bob Dylan has recorded his work. The group Canned Heat found inspiration in his unique guitar style. The Delta blues work of Son House, noted for his highly emotional style of singing and slide guitar playing, also adapted easily to more contemporary folk and rock genres. And let's listen to a more country version of House's song, Depot Blues, recorded by the Crowder Brothers in 1936. Kokomo Arnold, born in 1901, was a bootlegger and left-handed slide guitarist who took his name from the town of Kokomo, Indiana. He had an intense slide style of playing and rapid-fire vocal style that set him apart from his contemporaries. Arnold, like Son House, was also a major influence upon his musical contemporary, Delta blues artist Robert Johnson, and thus modern music as a whole. That influence is exceptionally notable as Johnson turned Arnold's old original Kokomo blues into Sweet Home Chicago and Milk Cow Blues into Milk Cow's Calf Blues, while another Arnold song, Sagefield Woman Blues, introduced the terminology Dust My Broom, which Johnson used as a song title for one of his own songs. But let's listen to Kokomo Arnold himself and his namesake song, Old Original Kokomo Blues.
I'm 1 and 1 is 2, mama. 2 and 2 is 4. You mess around, you pretty mama, you know we got to go, crying on. Baby, don't you wanna go back to the level light city, to sweet old Kokomo? Now 4 and 1 is 5, mama. 5 and 1 is 6. You mess around, you pretty mama, you're going to get me tricked, crying on. Baby, don't you wanna go back to level light city, to sweet old Kokomo? Now 6 and 1 is 7, mama. 7 and 1 is 8. You mess around, you pretty mama, you're going to make me late, crying on. Baby, don't you wanna go back to the level light city, to sweet old Kokomo? See, if I told you, mama, when you first fell across my bed, you've been drinking your old bad whiskey and talking all out your head, crying on. Baby, don't you wanna go back to level light city, to sweet old Kokomo? I don't drink because I'm dry, mama. Don't drink because I'm blue. The reason I drank with you, mama, I can't get along with you, crying on. Baby, don't you wanna go back to the level light city, to sweet old Kokomo? Now 8 and 1 is 9, mama. 9 and 1 is 10. You mess around, you pretty mama, I'm going to take you in, crying on. Baby, don't you wanna go back to level light city, to sweet old Kokomo? Now 10 and 1 is 11, mama. 11 and 1 is 12. You mess around, you pretty mama, you gon' catch a lot of hell, crying on. Baby, don't you wanna go back to the level light city, to sweet old Kokomo?
Like others of the time, many of Kokomo Arnold's songs spoke of hard life and troubles. But also, like others, such as Book of White, some of his lyrics were considered scandalous for the time. Another of his notable songs is the 1934 recording of Sissy Man Blues, with its openly bisexual lyrics, including the line, "Lord, if you can't send me no woman, please send me some sissy man." This piece became quite popular, however, and went on to also be recorded by other blues musicians of the era. You've been listening to another episode of The Roots and Reach of Music. The lives and careers of Son House and Kokomo Arnold demonstrate just how deep and long that is. In 1938, Arnold left the music industry and began to work in a Chicago factory. Rediscovered by blues researchers in 1962, he showed no enthusiasm for returning to music to take advantage of the new explosion of interest in the blues among young white audiences. He died in Chicago in 1968 of a heart attack. He was 67 years old. This is Suzy Q, and on that sad postscript, I'm going to leave you with Kokomo Arnold and a song he recorded in 1938, the last year of his musical career, Bad Luck Blues.
Now trouble, trouble, I've been at it all my days. Now it seems like trouble's going to put me in my lonesome grave. old uptown. I'm scared to stay here, scared to leave this old bad luck town. For when I wake up every morning, my head is going round and round. Now listen, young people, I don't want no one's advice. I don't want no one's advice. I done changed my way of living. Go find someone to treat me right. I'm going to tell everybody what bad luck I've had in my life. I kill my sister and my brother, not a woman die break my life.
This is Sharon Laborde, publisher at Cahaba Press, a small publishing house located in northwest Arkansas. Are you an independent author? Are you ready to publish your manuscript? I'll be happy to answer your questions about editing, formatting, and cover design. Details of the publication services offered at Cahaba Press are available on the website, CAHABAPRESS.com, or email me at publisher@cahabapress.com. I'll be happy to help you with your creative project.
The Ozark Harvest Radio Hour is a production of the Eureka Springs Independent and the Inside Straight and Thanatopsis Club. Richard Pillay, executive producer. Dan Croats, producer and writer. Dr. Sharon Sloan, technical director. Dr. Fred Mayer, director of music. G.K. Chesterton, director of philosophy and content. Jane Pillay and Bonifaci Fieger Gardening Consultants, Luca Brasi, Aquaculture Consultant, Eddie Kiever and the Fabulous Kiever Sisters, Advertising and Sales. The Ozark Harvest Radio Hour is organic radio, always fresh, always local, and always honest. We are community radio. That means that if you would like to appear on the Ozark Harvest Radio Hour, we have to put you on. Contact us at the Ozark Harvest Radio Hour.com, like us on Facebook, or look us up in the telephone book. Until next week, so long and be nice.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.